Good morning, students. In the last class, we have learned how to conduct certain tests by which we can recognize which particular nutrient is present in a given food item. And from all those tests, it is proved that every food item contains one major nutrient or at the maximum two major nutrients in it. Hence, if you take a food item, it may contain carbohydrates in large quantity in it, or it may contain fats in large quantity in it, and it may contain proteins in large quantity in it, but not all three in equal quantity. Any one particular nutrient is present in large quantity. Other nutrients may be present, may not be present. Even if they are present also, they are present in small quantity. Right. And we eat different food items expecting all the nutrients are provided to our body. But why should we take all the nutrients into our body? What is the need of every nutrient? Why not we can survive by taking any one nutrient only into our body? Why have we to take all the different types of nutrients for our better growth and development? Let us learn the significance of or importance of every nutrient. If you take carbohydrates and fats, from carbohydrates we get energy. From fats also we get energy. In fact, fats give more energy than carbohydrates. But fats cannot be easily utilized to get energy. If they are utilized, they give more energy. But mostly fats, they are used in construction of the body for sometimes, and sometimes they may be used for getting energy. But carbohydrates are used to get energy. Whatever it may be, both carbohydrates and fats, they give us energy. So the foods that contain carbohydrates and fats are called energy giving foods. Foods that contain carbohydrates and fats are called energy giving foods. Okay. And please remember, fats give more energy than carbohydrates. Okay. Examples, if you take the foods that contain carbohydrates: potato, sweet potato, wheat, rice, bajra, okay, sugar cane, all these things, and papaya, melon, mango, maize, all these things, they contain carbohydrates only. If you take milk, it contains both carbohydrates and fats. Except milk, keep it aside. Remaining all the products, potato, sweet potato, wheat, rice, bajra, sugar cane, papaya, watermelon, mango, maize, all these things are plant products only. That means, indirectly, it explains that we get carbohydrates only from plant products. From animal products, mostly we do not get carbohydrates. Fats we get, and carbohydrates we get from fats and carbohydrates together we get from milk, which is animal product. Of course, still it is considered as vegetarian food product. So from vegetarian food products only we get carbohydrates. Okay. And if you are expecting carbohydrates from non-vegetarian products, you cannot get carbohydrates. So The people who are eating only non-vegetarian products may not be getting the carbohydrates in the correct quantity, or may be getting very less quantity of carbohydrates. Okay. Proteins, next major nutrient. Proteins are needed for body growth and repair. Means, what is repair? Our body is keep getting exposed to different environmental pressures. Because of that environmental pressures, unknowingly our body is getting slight damage externally and internally, which we may not be able to notice sometimes. Then, how that damage is repaired? By using the proteins. Okay. So, little amount of fats also. But proteins are the major ones. See, if you look at fats, fats provide us energy along with carbohydrates. Fats help in repair along with proteins. So, but the major portion of work of fats is providing energy. Minor portion is providing the help in growth and repair. That's why we do not take fats under what? Bodybuilding food. We just give that fat portion to energy giving food only. Right? So, proteins are needed for body growth and repair. The foods that contain proteins, the foods that contain proteins are protein containing foods are called bodybuilding foods. They are called bodybuilding foods. And proteins are available from both plant products and animal products, unlike carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are available from only plant products, except milk. Whereas, proteins are available both from plant products and animal products. For your information, I am giving you the plant products that give proteins. Gram, okay, there are different types of grams. In your Kannada language, there are Uddi Bela, Dugri Bela, like many, Hesaru Bela, Kadali Beda. All these grams, they provide you, these are all grams, they provide you proteins. Moong dal, peas, beans, soya beans, all these are plant products from which we get proteins. And animal products from which we get proteins are chicken, meat, fish, beef, pork, milk, paneer, etc. These are all animal products. Okay. I have written chicken, meat, fish, beef, pork like this. What is this different terms? All these are commonly, they are flesh only. Flesh, that is mamsa. Okay, carcass. Chicken, it is the flesh of fowl, that is cocks and hens. Meat or mutton, it is the flesh of goat, sheep. Fish, of course, we use no term for it. Beef, it is the flesh of cows, ox, etc. Pork, it is the flesh of pig. So these are different terms for the flesh of different animals. Okay. Right. Milk, paneer, we know that they are available from animals only. Right. Now, coming to vitamins. Vitamins help in protecting our body against many diseases. Vitamins help in protecting our body against many diseases. Like, and they also help in keeping our eyes, bones, teeth and gums healthy. They also help in keeping our eyes, bones, teeth and gums healthy. Our eyes are kept healthy because of A vitamin. Our bones and teeth are kept healthy and strong because of D vitamin. And our gums, gums means the part above the teeth that is present inside your mouth. Okay, the gums are protected, healthy and strong because of C vitamin. And vitamins are of 6 types. They are vitamin A, B. There are many types of vitamins under B. So all together are called B complex vitamins. Vitamin C, vitamin D, vitamin E and vitamin K. Let us learn some more significance of these vitamins. If you take carbohydrates, proteins and fats, they are needed in large quantity as part of our diet. Whereas vitamins are needed only in small quantities as part of our diet. Let us take the importance of some vitamins. Vitamin A, it keeps our skin and eyes healthy. If your skin has to be healthy in condition, if your eyes have to be healthy in condition, then your food should contain enough amount of vitamin A. Vitamin C, it helps the body to fight against many diseases. That means our body has got a special system called immune system. This immune system function is, it protects our body from many diseases. So, especially viral diseases for which medicines are not there. Our immune system only has to act on it. If our immune system is strong enough, then viral diseases can be easily cured or can be easily eliminated from our body. If our immune system is weak, then viral diseases may cause large damage to our body. That is the reason in present coronavirus condition, people are advised to take vitamin C capsules or tablets to keep our immune system stronger. Okay? If any person is affected by corona or is recognized as corona positive, the doctors are prescribing C vitamin capsules so that the C vitamin capsules can keep the person's immune system strong and then the coronavirus can be eliminated from the body. Right? That's why I have done in COVID-19 protection, C vitamin helps. Right? Calcium is needed to keep our bones and teeth healthy and strong. Calcium, it is a mineral nutrient. It keeps our bones and teeth healthy and strong. In order to use calcium, vitamin D is needed because vitamin D helps our body to use the calcium. Vitamin D, it helps our body to use calcium so that our bones and teeth, okay, they are kept healthy and strong. Regarding other minerals and nutrients, sorry, other minerals and vitamins, and regarding water, regarding dietary fiber, okay, what is their significance? We will learn in the next class. Thank you.